Good morning, afternoon, or evening, dear yogis here at Yoga TX. My name is Echo, so thank you for being here with me, and Ohayo gozaimasu. I am tuning in from my little snowboard lodge here in Japan. And it is snowing outside, and it is chilly, and before I go ride in the powder, I am going to do my practice. And my offering to you today is a practice of discernment, is a practice of choice. In a world full of overstimulation, in a world full of so many ample choices, like what are the choices that we make? What do we feed each day? And it's important for our practice. You know, for me, my yoga practice is a time to really tune in with myself and what it is that it means to be an echo. You know, we each are acting, we are participating in the human experience as whomever it is that we are. And so I wake up in the morning and I think, oh, I'm wearing Echo again today. You know, this lovely mask. And Echo is a yoga teacher and a snowboarder. And Echo does this and Echo likes this. And that is ever changing. And what we act as each day is shifting. You know, maybe tomorrow when Echo wakes up, she's not a yoga teacher. Maybe she doesn't like snowboarding anymore. But for me to really know what it means to be myself is to explore the experience of humanity within myself. Meaning that when I come to the yoga mat, I get an opportunity to not be distracted by the world, to not be distracted by other humans, and to simply tune in to what I feel. What I feel is my truth, what it feels to be in this body, to breathe in this body, to be connected to this heart, to be connected to this mind. And that is ever changing. And for so many of us, most of us, we are trying to fit into so many boxes of I am a woman, I am a mother, I am a sister, I am a father, I am a husband, I am, you know, the owner of a company, I am an employee, I am this religion, this race, that gender. And we get so muddled in all the boxes that we are that we don't actually know what it means to be ourselves. And so I ask you today, as you tune into this practice and we move and we breathe, it's like, what does it mean to be a you? What does it mean to be the experience that is you? Because truly you're not just a person. You are an experience. You are having an experience of humanity within yourself, and that is shifting. And allow yourself to shift and choose and discern what it is that you need today in this moment, in this breath. So that being said, let's shut the eyes down. And drop your right ear to your right shoulder. Get nice and long through the left side of the neck. You can bring the left hand out to the left side. Get a little bit of a stretch. Let's come back through center, left ear to left shoulder. Right hand stretches out, left hand back on the knee. Come back to center. Inhale, stretch the arms up. Exhale, hands to heart center. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, heart center. Inhale, reach up. And exhale to the heart. Bowing head to heart. Intention for your practice, I am here. All of me is here. I allow, I welcome in whatever feels authentic today. Can open the eyes. And we're going to start standing. So let's go ahead and just stand right on up in our mats. And take an inhale, reach the arms up. And exhale, hands to heart. So we're getting nice and long through the side bodies. Get a stretch as you come up. Inhale, reach up. Slight back bend. Exhale, hands to heart. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, open. And hands to heart. Let's take an inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come up halfway, hands to shins, nice flat back. And exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway, engage the core. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway up. And exhale, fold. Plant the hands, step back to a plank position, top of the push-up. Press in through the palms, pull the belly in, straight line of energy from crown back through heels. Take an inhale. Exhale, press back, downward facing dog. So press the heels in, press the palms in. And we come into stillness. So finding some centering in our practice today, really embodying the masculine principles of just stillness, centeredness, focus. Sometimes on the yoga mat, we're given an opportunity when the mind is kind of all over the place, we're numbed out, to just simply be in one space, breathe deeply in and out of the nostrils. Slowly walk the feet towards the hands, take your time. Fold in, take opposite elbows. Hands to the earth, inhale, come up halfway, hands to shins, and exhale, fold. Inhale, rise to standing, reach up, and exhale, hands to heart. Inhale again, reach up, and exhale, fold. Inhale, up halfway. Exhale, plant the hands, step back to a plank position. Inhale here. Exhale, come down halfway, elbows in by the ribs. Inhale forward, open the heart space, thighs are lifted. Exhale, tuck the toes, use the core, draw the hips back. Downward facing dog. And even in your practice, decide, choose to be here. If the mind begins to wander, if the breath begins to wander, bring it back. We're going to find some plank waves now. So inhale, wave forward, rounding the upper back into your plank. Exhale, use the core, draw the hips back and up first. Let the head relax into that V shape. Inhale, wave forward, slink forward. The head comes out last. Exhale, core in, back, downward facing. Inhale, wave. Exhale, back. Again, inhale, wave. This time, let the hips drop, open the chest. We're still on the tiptoes here. Exhale, draw with the core back, hips up, downward facing dog. So we're dipping down into that upward facing dog with the toes tucked. Inhale, wave forward. Let the belly drop, open the chest. Exhale, hips first, head last. Inhale, way forward. Exhale, wave back. Beautiful. Big toes together. Come down onto the knees. Toes tucked. Sit back onto the heels. Favorite posture ever. Toe squat. And let's inhale. Reach the arms up. Clasp the thumbs. Open the chest. Bring hands to the lower back, make a fist, open the heart space here. And that heat is rising in the feet. Let it rise. Find your focal point, forward focus. Hands to the thighs. Sitting up nice and tall, relaxing the shoulders, the muscles in the face. Hands to the earth, untuck the toes, and tap out. Let's take an inhale, stretch the right arm out to the right side and open. Exhale, right arm underneath the body. Left arm stretches forward, we get into the right deltoid, opening the heart space, or opening the shoulder. And really press down through the right shoulder to look through to the left even more deeply, so twisting in. Bring the left hand back. Lift the right arm up. And exhale, lift, or the right hand down. Inhale, left arm up. And exhale, sweep the left shoulder underneath the body, right arm forward, twisting open. Can hear everyone in the lodge getting ready to go snowboarding today. Early morning, the powder is here, everyone's getting excited. Bring the right hand back, left arm reaches through, and bring it down. Let's tuck the toes, press the hips back and up, downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the right leg up, bend the right knee, stack the right hip open over the left. And really press the right knee up towards the ceiling, left heel down to the ground, so we're getting into the groin. Step the right foot through, left heel spins down. And let's come up to a side angle pose, right elbow on the right thigh, left arm stretching up and forward, opening the chest. Really strong in the legs here, press down firmly through the feet. Left hand to the back of the head, open the heart space. So you can press into the right knee with the right elbow, open through the chest, twisting open. And inhale, standing up, arms parallel with the ground, straighten the right leg. Bring the left foot in just a bit. Inhale, bring the right arm forward, right hand down to the right shin, left arm up. So engage through the core so we're not just hanging out on the right leg. Keep the hips facing to the left. Really engage the core. For a moment, stretch the left arm forward overhead, right arm forward overhead, like you're holding a giant beach ball. We're getting into the core. Bend the right knee, place the right hand down on the ground, lift the left leg up, coming into half moon. So right hand can stay on the earth or it can float. Left hip is stacking on top of the right. Left arm reaching up. Balancing on that right foot. It's all about balance. And let's step back to a high lunge. Left toes down. Reach the arms up. Hands to the earth. Pull the left foot in just a bit. Straighten the right leg and left heel sets down. Coming into that pyramid pose. Can come onto the fingertips or forehead towards the shin. Keep the right hip pulling back in space. For some of us, can maybe walk the fingertips back behind you as well. And for some, you might want your fingers on a couch cushion, bringing the earth closer to you. Just take an inhale, come up halfway. Exhale, plant the hands, step back to a plank position.
Lower halfway. Inhale, forward, upward facing dog. And exhale,
downward facing dog. Inhale, lift the left leg up behind you. Bend the left knee, stack the left hip open over the right. Step the left foot forward, right heel spins down.
Side angle pose here. Left elbow on the left thigh, right arm stretching up and over. Get nice and long through the legs, ground down through the feet. Right hand, come to the back of the head. Open the chest even more. Press the left elbow into the left thigh to open the chest up even more. Inhale up, arms parallel with the earth. Straighten the left leg, pull the right foot in just a little bit. Stretch the left arm forward and down. Right arm up, triangle pose. Engage through the core. Bring the right arm forward overhead, left arm forward overhead, holding that giant beach ball. Bend the left knee, left fingertips to the earth, right arm reaches up, right hip stacking on top. Ooh, if you fall out, you come back in. And maybe the left fingertips float, maybe not. This is my tricky side. You can use something to hold on with the left hand to bring the earth closer to you if you need. Really engage the core. Step back, high lunge. Ooh, that's a tricky side. And bring the hands down to the earth. Right foot steps in, heel down, straighten the left leg, fold over the left shin. Maybe the fingers walk back behind you, maybe not. Hands to the front. Step the right foot outside the right hand, left foot outside the left hand, and let's sink into a yogi squat. Elbows to the inside of the knees, setting up nice and tall. Maybe you need a couch cushion underneath the seat. We open through the hips, looking forward, find that focal point. Hands back behind you, come into a seat. Stretch the feet out in front of you. Let's take an inhale, sit up nice and tall. And the exhale slowly brings you forward. So if the spine begins to round, stay more straight. And then just keep the hands to the side of the body. Maybe you go a little bit deeper, maybe not. And we allow our exhale to take us deeper and deeper into this posture. So if you close the eyes and let gravity do the work, each exhale, even if it's just like a micro movement, the chest slowly gets a little bit deeper, comes down a little bit further towards the legs. Just come back up, bend the knees, and we find our boat pose. So arms alongside the body, knees bent, open the heart space, and begin to sink just until you find a little tremble. Find your focal point, really engage through the core. This is where a lot of our discernment comes from, our inner sun, our fire, our Agni. For five, four, three, two,
One, come back up in a controlled manner, sit up nice and tall, pause, close the eyes. So it's good to, in our practice, like have a bit of flow, but do something that's a bit challenging, that we want to run away from. It teaches us resilience and strength, that masculine principle of centeredness and forging a new path. Let's come back in, find your tremble, choose it, really choose it, the challenging part. Can you be with it? Don't run away. You got this. Come back up. Sit up nice and tall, long spine, shut the eyes down. And come back one last one. Let it shake. Let it be tough. Let it be a tremor. You really approach it with pride. You show up. Coming back up, find your seat, cross-legged, sitting up nice and tall, hands resting on the knees. Close the eyes, soften the muscles in the face. Breath moving in and out of the nostrils. Gonna rub the palms together, creating a heat. Bring the palms over the eyes. Deep breath in, deep sigh out. And knowing that everything that we need is right here internally, all the wisdom, power, the knowledge, it's all right here. Hands to heart center, bowing head to heart. We say namaste. Thank you, yogis, for being here. Feel free to subscribe for weekly classes. You can head over to my YouTube channel as well, Our Echo Yoga, for other classes and meditations and breath work. And to do individual work together, you can head over to echoflowyoga.com to see my offerings. I have online retreats and trainings and individual therapeutic sessions. And that's all. I welcome you to your day or your evening, and hope that you find some grace in being the version of yourself today that you are.